A warm welcome to all my friends, myself K. Guruswamy, Assistant Professor in Mathematics, CK College of Engineering Technology, Kadalur. The topic of my presentation is Linear Differential Equation with Constant Coefficients. Differential Equations. Before starting that, what is differential equation? Introduction. A differential equation is an equation that contains a derivatives. Remember that the derivatives represents a rate of change. It can be anything from population growth, planetary motion, etc. Applications of differential equation. Differential equations help us to understand phenomenal then rate of changes, spread of disease, weather and climate prediction, traffic flow. In engineering, it is widely used for suspension bridges, rockets, electrical circuits and signals and system and light damping, etc. Types of differential equation. Ordinary differential equation, partially differential equation, linear differential equation, non-linear differential equation, homogeneous differential equation, non-homogeneous differential equation. Ordinary differential equation. An equation contains only ordinary derivatives of one or more dependent variable of a single independent variable. That is dy by dx plus 5y is equal to e power x. Linear differential equation. A linear differential equation is one in which the dependent variable and its derivatives occur with first degree. That means x d square y by dx square plus y is equal to x square is linear. Non-linear. A differential equation which is not linear is called non-linear differential equation. Y dy by dx plus x square equal to 0 is non-linear. Ordinary differential equation. In that ordinary differential equation, we split into 5 topics. First topic one is linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Second one, Cauchy homogeneous linear differential equation. Third one, Legendre linear differential equation. Fourth one, method of variation of parameter. Fifth one, simultaneous first order linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Before starting that, we need some basic formulas. In that, differentiation formulas. It is nothing but differentiation of x power n. We reduce that power means n into x power n minus 1. Differentiation of x is equal to 1. Differentiation of constant is equal to 0. Differentiation of e power x is equal to e power x. Differentiation of e power ax is equal to a e power ax. Differentiation of 1 by x is equal to minus 1 by x square. Differentiation of sin x is equal to cos x. Differentiation of cos x is equal to minus sin x. Differentiation of tan x is equal to secant square x. Differentiation of cot x is equal to minus cosecant square x. Differentiation of secant x is equal to secant x tan x. Differentiation of cosecant x is equal to minus cosecant x cot x. Linear differential equation with the constant coefficient. This topic 1. In general form, the general form of nth order linear differential equation is a naught d power n y divided by dx power n plus a 1 d power n minus 1 y divided by dx power n minus 1 plus a 2 d power n minus 2 y divided by dx power n minus 2 plus dot dot plus a n minus 1 dy by dx plus a n y is equal to q of x. You consider that one is equation number 1, where a naught, a 1, a 2, dot dot, a n minus 1, a n are constants with a naught not equal to 0. If q of x is equal to 0, whenever q of x is equal to 0 means, then the equation 1 becomes a naught d power n y divided by dx power n plus a1 d power n minus 1 y divided by dx power n minus 1 plus dot dot plus an minus 1 dy by dx plus any is equal to 0. This one is considered in that left hand side, you consider f of capital D is equal to 0. Then equation 1 can be written as, in that equation 1, d power n y by dx power n, we consider capital D power n. D power n minus 1 divided by d power n dx power n minus 2, you consider capital D power n minus 2 plus dot dot plus dy by dx, you consider d and an equal to q of x. Here d equal to d by dx, d square is equal to d square y by dx square dot dot capital D power n is equal to capital D power n is equal to d power n divided by dx power n. These are called differential operators. That complete solution of y is equal to CFP plus PI. CF is nothing but complementary function, PI means particular integral. In that complementary function, we having that equation, it is in the form of a0 capital D power n plus a1 capital D power n minus 1 plus dot dot plus an minus 1 d plus an into y is equal to 0. You replace d implies m, means we get some solution a0 m power n plus a1 m power n minus 1 plus dot dot plus an minus 1 m plus an equal to 0. In that equation, in that CF having three cases. Case 1 is nothing but if roots are distinct or different. Different is nothing but m1 not equal to m2 not equal to dot dot mn or m. Okay, here roots are different. Whenever roots are different means then the CF is c1 e power m1x plus c2 e power m2x. Case 2. If roots are equal, equal is nothing but m1 is equal to m2 is equal to dot dot mn is equal to m, all the roots are here same, then the CF is c1x plus c2 into e power mx. In particular integral, equation 3 can be written as f of d into y is equal to q of x. Case 3, if the roots are complex, complex is nothing but m is equal to alpha plus or minus I beta. Here alpha is real part and beta is imaginary part. Then the CF is e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. Solve sum number 1. Solve d square plus 2d plus 1 into y is equal to 0. Here this one is what? F of d into y is equal to q of d. Here q of d value, that means right hand side value is 0. Whenever right hand side value values are 0 means you find only the complete solution of y is equal to CF only. Solution, therefore the auxiliary equation is, you replace d or d square, wherever d implies wherever d means you replace d implies m, then m square, we get m square plus 2m plus 1 is equal to 0. In that this one is called what, quadratic equation. In that quadratic equation you consider that constant term by factorization method. In that constant term 1 we split into what, by multiplication 1 ones are 1. Okay, then we add means we get that term m, the coefficient of m. What that coefficient of m? 2. 1 plus 1 value what? 2. Then the factors, therefore the factors are m1 plus 1 into m2 plus 1 is equal to 0. Here to equate each factor equal to 0 means we get m is equal to minus 1, another m2 is equal to, m2 value is equal to minus 1. Here roots are same, whenever roots are same means then the CF is y is equal to c1x plus c2 into e power mx. Therefore y is equal to c1x plus c2 into e power, replace m value minus 1. e power minus x. Problem number 2. Solve d square minus 5d plus 6 into y is equal to 0. Solution. Therefore, the auxiliary equation is, you replace d implies m, means we get m square minus 5m plus 6 equal to 0. Then by using factorization method, we get some factor. What you consider that constant term 6, we split into 2 3s are okay. I multiply that term, means what we get 6, that is a constant term. I add that term, means what 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. In that time we consider negative term. Okay, negative term of 2 means what? Minus 2. Here this one is what? Minus 3. Okay, minus 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 5. It is a coefficient of m. Here what that coefficient of m value? Minus 5. Both are same. Okay, here therefore the factors are m minus 2 into m minus 3 is equal to 0. Therefore roots are m1 is equal to 2, m2 is equal to 3. Here roots are different. Then the CF is c1 e power m1x plus c2 e power m2x. You replace m1 is equal to 2 and m2 is equal to 3, means we get y is equal to c1 e power 2x plus c2 e power 3x. Rules for finding particular integral. In that f of d, in that left hand side f of d y is equal to q of x, where f of d is equal to what? A naught d power n plus a 1 d power n minus 1 plus dot dot plus a n minus 1 d plus a n. Okay, that one is pi is equal to 1 divided by that left hand side value comes to right hand side, means 1 divided by f of d into right hand side value, what here q of x. Here right hand side value what? Q of x. Okay, this is type 1, this is a general form. Okay, here in that q of x values are e power ax sin ax or cos ax or x power n and e power ax g of x into g of x. The q of x contain any one of the values, means we get type we get some types. That is nothing but type 1. In PI, type 1 is nothing but q of x is equal to e power a x. Therefore, the PI is equal to 1 divided by f of d into e power a x. You replace in the type 1, means you replace the denominator in capital D, replace by a, means type 1. Okay, type 2 is nothing but q of x is equal to sin ax or cos ax. You replace in that the coefficient of x, means what? A. You replace m or d implies minus of a square. That means pi is equal to 1 by f of d into sin ax equal to 1 divided by f of d square into sin ax. Here in type 2, means we replace that wherever you see that d square, means we replace minus of a square. Okay. Then type 3 is nothing but in that RHS, that means q of x value is equal to x power m, means x power m. Okay, it is nothing but a pi is equal to 1 divided by f of d into x power m. Okay, try to convert this term into what? A binomial expansion. It is nothing but 1 plus or minus capital X or g of d in a whole inverse into x power n. Okay, by using binomial expansion, okay, 1 plus x whole inverse equal to here minus plus into minus, means minus plus, we get some alternative symbols, 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus dot dot etc. Then 1 minus x whole inverse, minus into minus means what? A plus. Here in that all the series are what? A positive. 1 plus x square plus x cube plus dot dot etc. 1 minus x whole inverse whole power minus 2 is equal to 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube. 1 plus x whole power minus 2 is equal to 1 minus 2x plus 3x square minus 4x cube. Problem number 3. Solve d square y by dx square plus 6dy by dx plus 5y is equal to e power 2x. Okay. Therefore, the complete solution of y is nothing but solution. Then the given equation is, you consider this term capital d square y by dx square, you consider capital d square y plus this one is 6 into capital dy plus 5 into y equal to e power 2x. You take outside the common element y, means we get d square plus 6d plus 5 into y is equal to e power 2x. Okay, in that right hand side q of x is equal to what, e power 2x. This is type 1, this goes to type 1. Therefore, the complete solution of y is equal to cf plus pi. In that problem, we find out complementary function and also particular integral. Okay, we consider that left hand side d square plus 6d plus 5 into y is equal to 0. Okay, then you replace d implies m, means we get m square plus 6m plus 5 is equal to 0 by using to solve quadratic equation by using factorization. Okay, in that factor is nothing but 5, m plus 5 into m plus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, to equate each factor equal to 0 means we get some roots. Here roots are different, m is equal to minus 5, another m value minus 1. Here roots are different means then the cf is c1 e power minus 5x plus c2 e power minus x. You find pi. Pi is nothing but 1 divided by that f of d value. Here f of d values means what, d square plus 6d plus 5 into e power 2x. Okay, in pi type 1 means type 1 means you replace d implies 2. That means 2 is nothing but the coefficient of x. Okay, in that denominator you replace that value, e power 2x divided by d value, you replace 2 means for d square plus d value 6 into d value 2 means 6 into 2 plus 5. Then you add that term 2 square value 4 plus 12 plus 5 is equal to e power 2x divided by 21. This is pi. Therefore, the complete solution of y is equal to cf plus pi. Okay, then problem number 4, solve d square minus 3d plus 2 into y is equal to 2 cos of 2x plus 3 plus e power 2x. Okay, therefore the complete solution of y is equal to cf plus pi 1 plus pi 2. Okay, the given equation is d square minus 3d plus 2 into y is equal to 2 cos of 2x plus 3 plus 2 e power x. Okay, in that problem we find out cf. Cf means complementary function, d square minus 3d plus 2 into y is equal to 0. Therefore, the auxiliary equation means you replace d implies m, we get m square minus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. Then the factors are m minus 2 into m minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, to equate each factor equal to 0 means we get m is equal to 2, another m is equal to 1. That is, here also what, roots are different. Then the cf is c1 e power x plus c2 e power 2x. Okay, in that problem we are having pi1 pi2. Procedure for pi1, I write down in that pi is equal to 1 divided by d square minus 3d plus 2 into 2 cos of 2x plus 3 plus 1 divided by d square minus 3d plus 2 into 2 e power 2x. Okay, it is nothing but in that 1 divided by f of d is common for this 2 pi's, pi1 plus pi2. We separate the two terms, means what, pi1 plus pi2. First of all, you find out pi1. Pi1 is nothing but 1 divided by d square minus 3d plus 2 into 2 cos of 2x plus 3. Here 2 is a constant term, so we get outside. Then here cos of 2x, the coefficient of x means 2. That means type 2. This one goes to, in that pi goes to what, type 2. Type 2 is nothing but whenever d implies d square implies, you replace only what, d square implies what? Minus of 2, minus of a square. Here a value 2 means minus of 2 square means minus 4. Okay, you replace only that value. Therefore 2 into 1 divided by minus 2 square minus 3d plus 2. It is nothing but 2 into 1 divided by, here what that value, 2 square value minus 4, minus 4 plus 2 means what? You add minus 4 plus 2 means we get minus 2, minus 3d cos of 2x plus 3. Then we get what? Conjugate. Conjugate is nothing but the negative symbol of that constant term. Here I take conjugate means minus 2 into minus 3d into 3d minus 2 divided by 3d minus 2. Therefore here in the denominator contains what? A square minus b square into a square minus b square. That means what? A plus b into a minus b. Therefore minus 2 into 1 divided by 3d plus 2 into cos of 2x plus 3. Then I take conjugate means minus 2 into 3d minus 2 divided by 9d square minus 4 into cos of 2x plus 3 equal to minus 2 into 3 into d cos of 2x plus 3 minus 2 into cos 2x plus 3 divided by 9. You will replace d square implies minus 4. That means what? Minus of 36, minus 36 minus 4 means what? Minus 40. Then we get minus 2 is common outside. Outside means what? Minus 2 into minus 3 sine of 2x plus 3 into 2. That is nothing but differentiation of cos means what? Differentiation of cos means minus sine of 2x plus 3. Differentiation of 2x means what? 2. Minus differentiation of sine x means what? 2 cos 2x plus 3 divided by minus 40, that term. Okay, therefore here I cancel this 2, minus 2 divided by minus 40. That means 1 by 20. I multiply 2 inside means what? Minus 6 sine of 2x plus 3 minus 2 into cos of 2x plus 3 equal to, again I take 2 is common term in numerator, means what? I cancel numerator on 2 and the denominator 20 means we get 10, minus 1 by 10, 3 into sine of 2x plus 3 plus cos of 2x plus 3. Therefore then this is what? Pi1. Then next we find out what? Pi2. Pi2 is nothing but 1 divided by d square minus 3d plus 2 into 2 e power x. Okay, here 2 is a constant means you take outside. Then next step, you replace d implies what? D implies 1. I replace d implies 1 means this value goes to 0. Whenever value denominator value goes to 0 means condition fail. Condition fail means you go to starting point of Pi2, multiply in that numerator x, at the same time denominator you take differentiation. Okay, here I consider that term d square minus 3d plus 2 I split into 1 divided by d minus 1 into d minus 2 factor. Okay, here 2 is a constant term, I take outside. So 1 divided by replace 2 value. Okay, here I write on this value d implies what? 1 minus 2 into d minus 1. Okay, it is nothing but whenever that denominator goes to 0 means that value what? Indeterminate means what? We go to starting step, multiply by what? X, at the same time take differentiation means 2d minus 3. You will put that value means we get minus 2 dot x into e power x. Therefore Pi is equal to Pi1 plus Pi2 equal to minus 1 by 10 into 3 sine of 2x plus 3 plus cos of 2x plus 3 minus 2x e power x. The general solution of y is equal to Cf plus Pi1 plus Pi2. Then we get that value. Therefore, y is equal to c1 e power x plus c2 e power 2x minus 1 by 10 into 3 sine of 2x plus 3 plus cos of 2x plus 3 into minus 2x e power x. Type 3. Type 3 is nothing but u of x is equal to x power m, where m is a positive integer. Pi is equal to 1 divided by f of d into x power m. It is by using binomial expansion. Okay, already we studied that formula. 1 plus x whole inverse means what? 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus dot dot etc. 1 minus x whole inverse means 1 plus x square plus x cube plus dot dot etc. 1 minus x whole power minus 2 means what? Minus into minus plus 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube plus dot dot etc. Okay. Then problem number 5, solve d cube minus d square minus d plus 1 into y is equal to 1 plus x square. Okay, therefore complete solution of y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. Solution. The next steps, the given equation is d cube minus d square minus d plus 1 into y is equal to 1 plus x square. Therefore, the complete solution of y is equal to cf plus pi. Find the complementary function. Complementary function is nothing but given equation. Consider the left hand side values is equal to 0. Okay. Then you replace d in place m means what? M cube minus m square minus m plus 1. Find its roots means you compare first two terms. Means first two terms I take common term means what? M square. I take a common term m square means m minus 1. Okay, here also I take minus 1 common term. Then that means m minus 1. Okay. Therefore, m square into m minus 1 minus m minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, it is nothing but m square minus 1 into m minus 1 equal to 0. That means to equate each term equal to 0 means we get final roots. M is equal to 1 comma 1 comma minus 1. Here first one is different. You write down different value, then another two values are same. That time I consider c1 into e power minus x plus c2 plus c3x e power x. Then you find pi. Pi is nothing but 1 divided by d cube minus d square minus d plus 1 into 1 plus x square. I consider this one is what? Type 3. Type 3 is nothing but x power m. 1 plus x power m. Okay. Try to convert into binomial expansion means I take rearrange that order. That is nothing but lowest order to highest term. Here lowest term 1. I take minus is common term means what? D plus 1 minus of d plus d square minus d cube. Okay, I write down that notation into what? 1 minus capital X whole inverse by using binomial expansion. Okay, I write down this one what? 1 minus capital X whole inverse means what? 1 plus x square plus dot dot etc. into 1 plus x square. Therefore, omitting the higher powers of what here? D cube minus d cube here also before omitting you expand that term d plus d square minus d cube whole square means what? D square plus d power 4 minus d power 6. You omitting that value what? D power 4 d power minus d power 6 and also minus d cube. That time we get add another term means what? 1 plus d plus 2 d square into 1 plus x square. Therefore equal to 1 plus you multiply 1 plus x whole square inside each and every term. That time we get 1 plus x square plus d into 1 plus x square plus 2 into d square of 1 plus x square. It is nothing but in that you take differentiation in that power numerator value contain d means you take differentiation. That is nothing but differentiation of 1 plus x square means what? 0 plus 2x. Okay, here also what first time you take 2 times differentiation because d square occurred there. You take 2 times differentiation means what? First time differentiation means 0 plus 2x. Second time means 2. Here 2 2s are 4. Then we get 1 plus x square plus 2 2x plus 4 is equal to 4 plus 1 value what 5. Rearrange that value highest to lowest order. X square plus 2x plus 5. Therefore, general solution of y, the solution of y is equal to cf plus pi. Therefore, y is equal to c1 e power minus x plus c2 plus c3 x into e power x plus x square plus 2x plus 5. Okay, thank you. Then next point.